Today we'll be looking at this parting off tool I purchased off eBay. It's got 16mm square shank and a 2mm insert on the end. I had a few problems with this, so let's go into the workshop and see what happened. Now, I've been shopping on eBay and I've bought this parting off tool, which comes with 10 inserts. It's a 16mm square shank. This insert's 2mm wide and just holds in, clamped with the Allen screw on the top. The only downside compared to the parting off tool I've been using, it's the same width, is that you're limited to the depth of cut, whereas on this tool I can move it out. Set the tool in the tool holder, and somebody asked me why I didn't have grub screws on here. It did originally have grub screws on this. I've changed it to cap heads for two reasons. One, being a bit taller, you don't get a swarf in the end as much, and the other thing, you'll see that on a grub screw the Allen key is always a lot smaller than on a cap head, so I've got a bigger Allen key and a bit more leverage on it than I could get on a grub screw. So I'll set this tool to centre height and we'll see how it cuts. So the first problem I have with this tool is that I can't go low enough, I can't set it low enough, because on my tool post this part of the tool holder is touching on the top of the cross slide. It won't go any lower than that, and I need to get it down another 20th. So the first thing I've done is put the tool in on its side so I can machine some off the bottom. Because you can't go any further in than that with the tool, I only need to machine up to the corner here. There's no point in machining all this off. In fact, if I leave that on, it will strengthen the, it'll give a bit more strength than taking a millimetre off there. So the next job, I've tightened this up, the next job is to get the tool level along the bottom to the chuck. I've mounted the dial indicator on a piece of silver steel, which I usually use to hold in the tool holder when I'm checking work. So I've gripped it on there, clamped it, so now I can turn it to get the height, move it in now onto the part, and just wind it across to get the parallel. Okay, this dial indicator is, each division is a tenth of a thou, so it's near enough zero there. Wind it along and it goes back just under zero at this end. So the base of that doesn't look very flat, half a thou. I'm only going to machine to there, zero there. That'll do. So next thing to do is put a milling cutter in the chuck. The biggest milling cutter I had was this one. As you can see there, I'd need to do two passes. So what I've done is put this fly cutter in, which will do it in one pass. I've not used it before for milling, so we'll see how we go. Bring the tool in. Lock the carriage. the finish is quite good. Feels flat, it looks worse than it is. I'll just file the sharp edges off and we'll see if I can get centre height on that. Using the height setting gauge, you can see it's just gone off zero. Top of the tool set at centre line, and I've got probably a millimetre clearance under the tool. Well, that's it from me. I hope you've enjoyed it. I think I'll go and check those bearings.